sieht sie nicht aus wie ich. Mag nicht, was ich mag. Redet nicht den ganzen Tag. Weiß sie, dass du an mich denkst? Glaubt sie, dass sie dich gut kennt? Mm, sie bleibt dir fremd, sie bleibt dir fremd. War das nur ein One-Night-Stand? Oder glaubst du, dass sie um dich kämpft? Tu doch bitte nicht verliebt, wenn du sie nicht liebst. Ich glaub dir kein Wort, weil du immer lügst. Damit sie das wissen, sag mir wann, dass du mich noch nicht vergessen kannst. Damit sie das wissen, sag mir wann, sag mir wann. Ich weiß, dass du immer allein bist.
Wunder dich nicht, der rote Lippenstift ist von einer anderen Frau mit dem breiten Arm am See. Denn das mit uns war zwar echt, aber nur ein schlechter Traum bei einer.
Hallo there! And welcome to the last episode of my City Update 6 series, where I fly different general aviation aircraft in southwest Germany. And so far we have seen many very, very beautiful cities with very decent updated photogrammetry. So this is episode 4, and I am currently at the airport of Stuttgart, or Flughafen Stuttgart, as they would say, in Germany. And for this last episode, I am going to fly south down to Bodensee, or Lake Constance. And I have chosen an aircraft for this leg. I am even a little bit excited about it. It is an aircraft that I have not used for a while. It has sort of disappeared a little bit in the increasingly large selection of payware aircraft that I have. I did enjoy it quite a lot at the release, but since then I have bought quite a few Black Square aircraft, which are all excellent. So it is not very far down to our destination of Friedrichshafen, but we have not flown a turboprop yet. Have flown ultralights, and we have flown in the last episode we flew a turbocharged piston, the Black Square Bonanza, and we have even flown a piston twin, the 414 Chancellor. So I think it is only appropriate that we use an aircraft in the turboprop family. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the very excellent Kodiak by Simbrief Studios. I've had it for quite a while, ever since the release, I think. I really like turboprops. Something about the powerful engines, the versatility, and as for the Caravan and the Kodiak, they are very capable aircraft. They are able to fly quite high and even get into the smallest airstrips in remote locations. So I think these type of aircrafts are indeed very, very exciting. The Kodiak is a little bit special because way before I knew about MSFS, I did follow a YouTube channel by Missionary Bush Pilot, I think it's called, where he flies to different destinations in Papua New Guinea. And this looks very, very nice indeed. It is modeled very well in the exterior. So, and I guess we are all wondering about how the flight model is. I can't remember, because it's been a while now since I last flew it. So that is something I am very curious about. I did spend some time earlier today on flightsim.to because I thought it would be appropriate to find a German registered livery. And I did. So I'll put the link in the description below. Not only is the Kodiak a very capable aircraft, but it is also a very nice sightseeing aircraft because of the high wing, much like the Caravan. The Simbrief Studios Kodiak comes in many different versions. There's two main types, which is the wheeled version and also the float plane version. I've not tried the latter one yet. Should be fun though. And the wheeled version comes with different sets of wheels. And as you can see, these wheels here, they look quite large, don't they, and robust. They are indeed tundra tires. Tundra. Just as I was loading up Navigraph today, there was an update. So I have been subscribing to Navigraph for many years now, and it keeps getting better and better. Not only do you get the updated IRAC nav data once a month, but it also has a very excellent Navigraph charge application for your desktop and also for your mobile device, at least for iOS. So this update includes two new features, and one is an added land cover layer with forests and glaciers for enhanced situational awareness. So that should help with the VFR flying. As it says here, allowing for an even easier VFR navigation experience. The other one is a Terminator layer depicting the border between the daylit side and the dark night side of Earth. Sort of what you see in the world map menu when you set up a flight in MSFS. So we can see the Terminator layers here. So what is this new land cover layer? Well, the menu here is a bit extensive, so first I will show you that I'm using the world map, so I prefer that. Even with the IFR flights, I just like having the city names and so on. And there is also a VFR map, which includes some additional information, as we can see here. Zoom up to Stuttgart. Yeah. But I'm using the world map. And if we go here to the map layer selector, then you can choose a variety of options. This one is important to see the VORs and the Bs and stuff. And, it is accessible from here. How wonderful. The airspace I don't really pay attention to. So let's first look at the new feature here, which is the it's a submenu and submenu. So we have the Terminator layer and also the land cover, which was forests and glaciers, I think it was. Yeah, so that should aid us even more. The map is becoming more and more detailed. As you can see here, we have the infamous DX12 terrain bleed through issue here at the handcrafted airport of Stuttgart, which is included in World Update 6, I believe. So, of course, it is very horrendous when this happens, but there is a fix. It's only a temporary fix, though. But what you can do is that you go to the general options, developer, and then developer mode, and then you go to debug here, and then airport, and then you just select draw debug, right? And then there will be some weird lines and stuff. Don't worry about that, because you just want to go back and then deselect that one. All right, and then we'll go back into normal mode. Now voila, debug is gone. So one thing that I wanted to show you real quick is that since the Kodiak is using the G1000 system, which doesn't have touchscreen, you have to enter the flight plan in the unit using the knobs, which can be a bit of a hassle. And a nice and comfortable workaround is to import the Simbrief flight plan into MSFS. And there is a way to do that using Simbrief downloader. So you just have to select FS2020 here, and then it should automatically find the download directory for you. And then you just just double check that you have the correct flight plan. And then you hit export selected formats, and it says that it already exists, so we just overwrite it. And then we just get rid of that one. We can even shut it down if we are able to. I'm not really able to right now because it's in here, but I don't think it's using much system resources. So let's not worry about that. To actually load the flight plan, you just hit space, not that, but space, and then load from this PC, and then it should enter the folder, and then you just select the flight plan, which in our case is EDDS-EDNY, Stuttgart to Friedrichshafen. And then you open it, should take a little while, but there you go, and we have the departure runway, and we have the departure here, the SID, and we also have the arrival, but we do not have the approach yet, and that is fine. The thing now is that unless you want to start on the runway, you have to actually zoom in, then find a stand. I think I was using 62 or 63. We can use 63 like that. And while this very nice parallel 42 striper loading screen is showing, I'll just talk a little bit about the flight plan for today. So as I told you, we are of course going down south to Stuttgart, and you can actually see it here. It is not a very long flight, and just for some fun, we are going to use Beyond ATC, at least for the initial part of the flight plan, and probably not for the whole one. So that is actually why I have created the flight plan. I probably wouldn't have bothered with it in the first place, but you need a Simbrief flight plan apparently for Beyond ATC to work correctly, and currently it doesn't support VFR flights, so it is IFR only. So let's just have a look at the flight plan. We are departing from runway 07 using the Sol 1K departure. And we are ready now, so we will just close GSX and also parallel 42's flow. And like that. So, like in a lot of my recent videos, I am using Active Sky. I don't think I have done a single flight without it, in fact, since I got it. And I am using historical weather mode. The reason for that is that it is getting a little bit late here in Europe. And yeah, of course, the time in Stuttgart is the same as the time where I am, since I am in Norway, so that is Central European time. So it is getting a little bit late, and it will probably be dark soon, or at least before we finish our flight. So I have selected a different time. We can see the meter for the current time. This is the latest meter. It is not too bad actually, with broken clouds and a temperature of 13 degrees. But in Active Sky, I have selected a somewhat random time here at approximately 11 Zulu, which is 1 p.m. local. And I have set the sim time to approximately the same time here. Just so that we can fly during daylight hours and use the same weather that existed at that time. All right. So I will not spend too much time talking about that now because I have covered it quite extensively in my latest videos. All right. So let's start up the aircraft. I have revised the checklist, but I might not remember everything, so please bear with me. I will certainly do my best. So, battery goes to on, and the avionics bus on, beacon lights on, and then the fuel shutoff valves goes to on, like that. Then we hit enter here on the G1000. A very important thing, a requirement to get fuel into the engine is to bring the firewall fuel shutoff to the down position. Then, next step is to turn the aux fuel pump to on, ignition to on. And the procedure is as follows. After we put the starter switch to the high position, then we look here at the engine instruments, and when NG is 14%, the condition lever goes to low idle. And after that, we have to monitor the ITT for a hot start and the NG for a hung start. So let's try and see if I can get a view. Maybe not like that. It's difficult, isn't it? I haven't set up a custom view for this. So I want to see the condition lever, and maybe that is as good as it gets. So I will bring the starter to the high position, and we have a look for the NG. That's about 14%, so low idle. And look at the ITT and the NG. ITT is rising. It's looking good. So at 50%, the starter goes to off. Ignition goes to off. And then the aux fuel pump goes to standby. I think it's looking good, yeah. ITT is okay. was a little bit high initially there. We could probably have the prop back to low at the moment. So then we just leave the condition lever in low idle until we are at the holding point. And then aux bus goes to on. Generators has to be on because the battery won't last long. We might turn the nav switch into the on position. And I think also the taxi lights. And we can just turn on the instruments lights as well. We don't need the pyto and... No, we don't need the pyto heat because the temperature is above 5 degrees. I think that was what it said in the checklist. So, we can see here on the G1000 that the flight plan from Simbrief is now in the system here. We can increase the range. Then we see that we are going to take off from runway 07 and that is our departure. So the next step is to get the ATIS, and for that we are going to start Beyond ATC. And this is the third update since it released a few days ago, I think. So I had some issues with it that I lost. Suddenly the trigger button that I'm using for push to talk was not working, so we have to have a look at that. It says trigger button here, so let's just test it. Let's just test it real quick. So now it's not working. So this is some bug in the latest update. So the workaround is that because when I press the trigger button, nothing is happening here. We should see something. So the workaround is to disconnect the controller where the button is located and then reconnect it. Then we'll try again. It's working. So I hope it is working. I heard some strange sounds there. So let's put the view like this. So the first step is to click on this headphone symbol and then select the ATIS frequency.
Forecast. Temperature 13, 2.09. QNH 1017. Landing and departing runway 07. Transition level 050. Temporary flight restrictions are in effect for Stuttgart. Advise on initial contact, you have information, Mike. Stuttgart Airport information, Mike. 1650 Zulu. Wind 020 at 9, ceiling 3000 broken. For 600 overcast. Temperature 13. 2.09. QNH 1017. Landing and departing runway 07.
Alright, so that was information Mike and QNH 1017. And of course, Beyond ATC is using live weather at the time, and we are using historical weather, so there is a mismatch there. We have to use the altimeter setting that corresponds with the ATIS in Beyond ATC. Alright, and the flight plan was made using live weather as well. So the next step is to get the IFR clearance. So let's see if I can do that. It is very useful to leave this window open if you are trying trying this out for the first time, so it's helpful to see the text when you are going to do the readback. And our call sign, I have some issues with. It's a bit of a tongue twister for me. For some reason, it is Foxtrot, Foxtrot, Oscar X-ray. I have some issues with it. Foxtrot, Foxtrot, Oscar X-ray. It's not the easiest for me to pronounce. So I have to just think for a little while. This is unfamiliar for me. I have never used voice-based ATC before in the sim. So let's see. It would be something like Stuttgart delivery, Foxtrot, Foxtrot, Oxford. Yep. See. Stuttgart delivery, Foxtrot, Foxtrot, Oscar. No. Stuttgart delivery, Foxtrot, Foxtrot, Oscar X-ray. Request IFR clearance with information. Mike, maybe? I'm going to struggle with that one. I'm almost at the stage where I want to change it to something different because. Yeah, I think I will do that just to reduce my stress level a little bit, and then I can spend a day when I walk in the park when it's sunny outside, and then I can just repeat Foxtrot, Foxtrot. See. I can do that. I can practice it, but right now I'm going to file a new Simbrief plan, and I am going to use Uniform November X-ray, which was my the call sign for my very first airplane during my PPL training, which was a Cessna 152 in Australia. So I will be right back when I am Uniform November X-ray. Stuttgart delivery, Uniform November X-ray is ready to copy IFR clearance with information India.
Uniform November X-ray, Stuttgart delivery, thanks for information India. Expect runway 07, so 1 kilo departure. Squawk 1000.
Expect the runway 07, Sol 1 kilo departure, squawk 1000, Uniform November X-ray. Much easier with that call sign.
Uniform November X-ray, read back correct. Contact ground 118.6 when ready for start or taxi.
Ground 118.6 when ready for start or taxi, Uniform November X-ray. Alright, so let's go prop full then. And I think we're just gonna use the first station flaps on this long runway here. Just scan through here, we have the taxi lights on, and I think everything is looking good. It's not a very complicated aircraft. One thing to keep in mind though is the rudder trim, because this aircraft, the engine, it is a very powerful engine which produces a lot of torque, which you have to counteract with the rudder during the takeoff roll, and also actually when flying, I've noticed. So to do that, you should probably trim the rudder, I think, to the right before takeoff. Well, we should get going. Request taxi to runway, maybe. Stuttgart ground, Uniform November X-ray, request taxi to runway.
Uniform November X-ray, runway 07, taxi via Mike, Lima 2, India.
Runway 07, taxi via Mike, Lima 2, India, Uniform November X-ray.
Negative, taxi via Mike, Lima 2, India.
Isn't that what I said? And then we could use the what was it called again? my memory is so bad now. There's fire action one. I think it is this button here.
Runway 07 taxi via Mike, Lima 2, India, uniform November X-ray.
Alright. Just have to get comfortable here in the cockpit and see if can we go straight ahead. I think that might be maybe a little bit difficult, so what about if we turn to the left then? But then we have the little person here that we might injure, don't we? We have a very, we have high enough wings to clear his head, so he should be fine. It's a little bit hard to turn. We can turn to the right, actually. Yeah, I think that's the most sensible option. So let's go to the taxi view here. And then apply a little bit of power. Probably don't need much at all. Then we'll go over to the right first. And probably a good idea to have a little look at the map since I'm not extremely familiar with this airport. But I think I'm headed in the general direction which I'm supposed to be heading. I'll even have a look here. Mike, Lima 2. Yeah, so we're on Lima 1. Mike, Lima 2, India. That is Lima 2, so that is looking quite good.
Uniform November X-ray, contact Stuttgart Tower 119.05.
119.05. Contact Stuttgart Tower 119.05, uniform November X-ray. Alright, so I made it to the holding point of runway 07. Stuttgart Tower, uniform November X-ray is at holding point runway 07.
Uniform November X-ray, request not understood.
Alright.
Uniform November X-ray. Holding short, runway 07.
That sounds much better.
Uniform November X-ray, backtrack runway 07. Call when ready for departure.
Excuse me?
Backtrack runway 07, call when ready, uniform November X-ray.
Pardon? Runway 07, backtrack. Call when ready for departure. Alright. That's something new. And I have way too many windows open, as always. Don't really need to edit the video now. Yes, yes, yes. Backtrack runway 07. Alright.
Uniform November X-ray, ready for departure, runway 07.
Uniform November X-ray, Stuttgart Tower, wind 020 at 7, runway 07, cleared for takeoff.
Runway 07, cleared for takeoff, uniform November X-ray. We are going. Sure that this one is set correctly. And off we go. Lot of what? Ah. Always something. Yeah, so I'm having a yet another perfect storm of all possible bad things happening simultaneously, so I just had to restart to the runway because some crazy issue I had with the sim. And this time it was actually not my fault, which it usually is. So it seems that it is possible to start Beyond ATC from the current position. So let's give it a go. I've had a lot of issues today, so I'm sort of running out of patience. I just want things to work. I just want to fly. I just want to see Bodensee. I want to see the Alps.
Uniform November X-ray, holding short, runway 07.
Oh, Uniform November X-ray, have Stuttgart to be Tower, kidding me.
0 at Niner, runway 07, line up and cleared for takeoff.
Enough already. Line up and cleared for takeoff, Uniform November X-ray. Please, have mercy.
No. Uniform November X-ray, line up and cleared for takeoff, runway 07.
No. You know, I think I've had it for today. Sorry, it's just too many things happened before starting the video. Line up and cleared for takeoff, runway 07, Uniform November X-ray. Is that it then? Cleared for takeoff? Off we go. Sorry that I got upset there. Sorry. At least the rudder trim seems to be working. You see here on the sort of side slip indicator, I think it's called. So I think 85 initially is good. And then that was probably a bit too much up in the air, so we have to trim back now, the rudder trim. That's perfect. And then lower the nose, go flaps up. And trim up, and we will aim for 101 knots. That's about good. All right. I can just regain composure. Try with this one then.
Uniform November X-ray, reset transponder. Squawk 1000.
Probably a good idea, yes. 105 knots. And the torque is good, we can reduce it a little bit. The prop is good. And then if I had a co-pilot now, but it's possible to fly this engine single-handedly. It is down here. So
Uniform November X-ray. Yes.
Yes.
Squawk 1000.
Code 1000. And then Alt. 1000. Yes, my mistake. Forgot about that one.
Uniform November X-ray Stuttgart Tower.
Squawk 1000. Uniform November X-ray.
Maybe I should have squawked ident. Actually.
Uniform November X-ray, contact Langen radar departure 125.05.
125.05. Contact the Langen radar departure 125.05. Uniform November X-ray. Langen radar, Uniform November X-ray at 5000 feet.
Uniform November X-ray Langen radar departure identified. Climb to flight level 080.
Climb to flight level 080, Uniform November X-ray. So we will just go 6000 first, because it sort of takes ages to change this. And then we'll just hit 2000 here, and then when we're at approximately 105, was it 8?
Uniform November X-ray, contact Frankfurt radar 127.6, have a good day.
Caution, auto off, yeah, that's fine. My co-pilot will handle it.
Contact Frankfurt radar 127.6.
That should be fine.
Uniform November X-ray.
And then they want us to put the pyro on, which might be a good idea, because the temperature is less than 5. We're also in visible moisture, so yeah. What was that? It is Frankfurt radar. Okay. Frankfurt radar, uniform November X-ray, is climbing flight level 080, I think.
Uniform November X-ray, Frankfurt radar. Continue climb to flight level 080.
Continue climb to flight level 080, uniform November X-ray. Let's just have a look at the engine instruments here. Because prop in climb is 2000 to 2200. Torque we can probably increase a little bit to get the best performance. And why aren't we not climbing to 8000? That is because I couldn't bother to set it more, because it is relatively slow, but it's okay. We'll go vertical speed then, and then the same crash. You have to be kidding me. I mean, am I cursed? Oh my god. Oh no, no. Help. How painful is this? I have seen this one before, but I have not seen it in ages. It's some sort of bizarre CTD error message. Because I know that the 4090 is probably not overheating. My god, this takes forever. I mean, maybe scrolling is faster actually. Still not very fast though. Alright, so it seems that I am back in the sim. And I am on the correct runway, and I have restarted the computer, so I was just going to say, surely there can't be anything else, but there is. Yeah, I guess some days are not meant to be simming. I could use a drink, actually. Park brakes off. And let's go. So I think the rudder trim is quite good. I'm hardly using much rudder at all. So that is very useful. Okay, I think we can rotate. Just remember to reset the elevator trim. Very, very important. So we'll aim for about 85 here. A little bit down, trim down. Try not to drift off too much. And flaps up. And we'll try with a bit of autopilot. Then, if I could have just taken that one down, let's see. Torque, maybe reduce a little bit. Didn't need to go autopilot on there, but I just felt like having some assistance. So we need to reset the rudder trim now. there.
Uniform November X-ray, reset transponder. Squawk 1000.
Is set to 1000, so what about ident?
Squawk 1000, uniform November X-ray.
But I was...
Uniform November X-ray, contact Langen radar departure 125.05.
Okay, you can handle that, please.
Contact Langen radar departure 125.05, uniform November X-ray.
And she can handle the next one too, I think, since she is doing such a good job.
Langen radar, uniform November X-ray, 3,500 feet.
Oh, altimeter, altimeter,
uniform
altimeter.
November X-ray, Langen radar departure. Good day.
That's 1018.
Climb to flight level 080.
Climb to flight level 080, uniform November X-ray. Yes, 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 yes.
No! No!
Line up and cleared for takeoff, uniform November X-ray.
In this proud land we grew up strong.
No. Uniform November X-ray, line up and cleared for takeoff, runway 07.
I was taught to fight.
Line up and cleared for takeoff, runway 07, uniform November X-ray.
Thought I could fail. No fight left, or so it seemed. I am a man whose dreams have all deserted. I've changed my face, I've changed my name. But no one wants you when you lose.
Don't give up, 'cause you have.
Zero, zero, zero.
Uniform November X-ray.
Uniform November X-ray. Contact Langen radar departure 125.05.
Contact Langen radar departure 125.05. Uniform November X-ray.
I never thought that I could be affected.
Langen radar, uniform November X-ray, 3,000 feet.
I thought that we would be the last to go.
Uniform November X-ray, Langen radar.
It is so strange, the way things turn. Drove the night toward my home.
Climb to flight level 080, uniform November X-ray.
And as daylight broke, I saw the earth.
Alright, so after a world of misery, because everything that could go wrong went wrong, I am back. And the aircraft seems a bit squirrelish in the yaw axis, maybe because of the turbulence, I'm not really sure. But I'm having some trouble trimming it. Let's see here. Yeah, so we're on Langen radar.
Uniform November X-ray. Contact Frankfurt radar 127.6.
127.6. Contact Frankfurt radar 127.6. Uniform November X-ray. Frankfurt. Frankfurt radar, uniform November X-ray is at 6000, climbing flight level 080.
Uniform November X-ray, Frankfurt radar, continue climb to flight level 080.
Continue climb to flight level 080, uniform November X-ray. Alright. So at least I'm back up in the air. I don't really know where to start because everything sort of happened. But I don't want to. Overload this last episode of my City Update 6 series with venting my frustration. Yeah, that's fine. My heart skipped a few beats there, actually. I just want to have a nice flight, actually. Yeah. So, long story short, MSFS CTD'd several times after each other. And then eventually on the third attempt, of course, Windows 11 crashed. So I had to do a lot of troubleshooting. Frankfurt radar, uniform November.
Uniform November 3, request not understood.
Frankfurt radar, uniform November X-ray, request IFR clearance.
Uniform November X-ray, Frankfurt radar, expect runway 07, Sol 1 kilo departure. Squawk 1000.
What?
Sol 1 kilo departure. Squawk 1000. Uniform November X-ray.
Uniform November 83, read that correct.
Yeah, I'm a little bit confused, but I did start on the runway though. So, yeah. Alright, so we are up in the air. Let's have a look outside the aircraft here. It's not looking too bad. Oh, hello! I didn't know that you were here. How lovely. That was a pleasant surprise, actually, after all my ordeals. I thought I was alone in the cockpit, but I have company, yay. So this is active sky historical weather from approximately 11:30 Zulu, I think it was. Yeah, we can probably go to low idle even. Not to cut off, that would be a terrible mistake. Hey, whoops, and that was the wrong button. Just trying to decide on the view here. I set up a few other views in the Kodiak. So you can see it's a very nice sightseeing aircraft. I would love to be a passenger on this flight, actually. Just to relax and chill, you know, maybe with a little drink. I'm not flying. Hypothetically, if I was a passenger in my own virtual plane, yeah, that would be something. So I think these views are quite nice, and it is a relatively large cabin. I think the aircraft can take 9 passengers, actually. As you saw from the initial part of the video, it is a very capable aircraft. So, for this last episode, we are heading south towards the Alps. And our destination is the city of Friedrichshafen. Let's try that again. Deep breath. Friedrichshafen. or something similar, which is at the Lake Constance or Bodensee. I think it is a very nice place, and I think also that I really have to retrim the rudder, as you can see here on the indicator here, the sort of white line. You want to keep that centered. And so I don't think I've had, maybe other than the TBM 850 by Black Square, I haven't had any other aircraft that requires rudder trimming. So we actually have to trim a little bit more. Yeah, so let's have a look at my extensive Word document, which was only supposed to be one page long. And it is... I have no idea what happened. I have spent more time preparing for this flight than I, you know... is it like only 30 minutes into the video? Of course, I haven't finished editing it, so I have no idea. But 6 pages, you know, I wrote an essay. So, just a short recap for episode 1. We visited Mannheim and Heidelberg in the Cessna 414 Chancellor. Very powerful twin piston in episode 2. Karlsruhe, Kehl, and the French city of Strasbourg in the Cessna 152 and the ultralight Sting S4. And in the last episode, we went over to Stuttgart and Esslingen. Esslingen was a very, very lovely little town. Very scenic. And we used the turbocharged Bonanza from Black Square. So, and you have seen the amazing specifications for the Kodiak. It's quite impressive, so I'm thinking to test these capabilities and do some short field takeoffs and landings. I'm sure we will find some nice rural grass strip runways somewhere. Everything okay here? Yeah, apparently. So that'll be fun. So we are heading south to Friedrichshafen, which is a city on the shore of Lake Constance, or Bodensee in German. And it is known for its importance in aviation history, extensively documented in the Zeppelin Museum. A Zeppelin. Cafes dot its lakeside promenade. Steel tower on the lake's pier offers views of the city and the Alps. It's very close to the Alps, actually. The domed baroque towers of the palace church dominate the skyline and are visible from the air on Zeppelin tours. But do not get your expectations up too high, because this is not an enhanced city. In the city update 6, it is, however, an enhanced airport, which is Friedrichshafen Airport, also called Bodensee Airport. It is an international facility located on the northeastern periphery of the German city of Friedrichshafen, that lies less than 2 miles inland of the north shore of Lake Constance, one of Europe's largest lakes. Didn't know that, actually. Wonder which one is the largest. So, first I want to mention 2 extremely important things. Maybe the one most important thing of all when you're flying this aircraft, before taking off, please remember to reset the elevator trim, because I think it's up here somewhere, and that will not turn out very nice or pleasant, or it will not be a happy ending, you know, because the aircraft will go skyrocket towards the moon. Although that is trimmed down, actually, so probably it will not be a very good takeoff anyway. Just have it neutral. And the other thing is to use some rudder trim for takeoff. So have a look at the turn, the rudder trim indicator here, and put it maybe in the middle on the right side. Normal landing, you are both actually normal and short field landing. You should go condition lever high idle. And for the short field landing, you should use flaps full and aim for 74 knots. And you should apply beta range after touchdown, max brakes, and max brakes. And then yoke should go full aft. And then flaps up. So as I was pulling my hair out in deep frustration over all the misery that happened with all the CTDs and then eventually the Windows 11 crash, I was actually about to give up, but I really, really wanted to make this flight today. I've been looking forward to it. So we are above the clouds here. A very thick cumulus cloud. Yeah, I keep inventing new words. I had one in the last video, I think, but I've forgotten. Cloud layer, maybe? Clayer? Yeah. Definitely icing conditions at 1 degree Celsius and visible moisture. Not sure if we are actually near any airports within 80s, maybe Echo, Delta, Tango, Mike. Would be interesting to know the active sky weather. So why don't we tune 122.00, which is the closest airport, and listen to the active sky 80s.
Echo Tango Golf Zulu Airport information. Echo 1150 Zulu. Weather wind 2-4-6 at 7. Visibility 10,000. Sky condition few clouds at 1,000. Ceiling 2,400. Broken ceiling 4,500. Overcast. Temperature 12 QNH 1015. Advise on initial contact. You have information. Echo.
Uniform November 83, Frankfurt Radar. Expect gun 2 Papa, runway 24.
Say again, please. Uniform November X-ray.
Uniform November 83, Frankfurt Radar. Expect gun 2 Papa, runway 24.
2 Papa, runway 24, but I didn't get the rest.
GARM 2 Papa, runway 24, uniform November X-ray.
So I think what we might do actually is GARM 2 Papa. It would have been useful if I had looked at my own flight plan and runway 24. Okay. So what we might do, because I don't think we are that far away now from Friedrichshafen. I think it's very tricky to try and say in German when you are not German or Austrian or yeah.
Uniform November X-ray, descent to 4,000 feet, QNH 1018.
1018. Sent to 4,000 feet, QNH 1018, uniform November X-ray.
Uniform November X-ray QNH 1018, expect the ILS runway 24 with the mocap transition.
She can handle that one.
QNH 1018, expect the ILS runway 24 with the mocap transition. Uniform November X-ray.
Uniform November X-ray, clear direct mocap. Cross mocap at or above 4,000 feet, cleared ILS runway 24.
She can help us.
Clear direct mocap. Cross
yeah, we're going direct mocap. So what we're going to do is we're going to go in FLC mode with 140 knots, and then we'll just reduce the thrust.
Uniform November X-ray. Contact Munich radar 120.65.
And then we can adjust the vertical speed with the throttle lever. contact Munich radar 120.65 uniform November X-ray. Munich radar uniform November X-ray is at 7,100 feet, descending 4,000 feet.
Uniform November X-ray, Munich radar, roger.
And we will use this one as an overlay. We're almost at the mock-up now. And the frequency is 111.9. So we have to do something a little bit experimental. And we have to increase the thrust. And I don't know why we are at, was it 4,000? Oh dear. This is Captain Piett just messing things up, as usual. Yes. Nothing to see. Move along, move along. 4,000. I've been very distracted today because of all these issues. Alright, so back to mock-up at 4,000. Yes. Reduce the throttle again. And we might as well go condition liver high so that we remember that at least. And because there are two different sort of instructions, it is expect ILS24 and cleared ILS24. So I think we are cleared to proceed with the approach. And we are at the correct altimeter. So that Beyond ATC is happy. Of course, we're using a completely different weather, so that is probably not smart in any way. Alright, so it seems that we are heading back to mock-up. Sorry, that was just me changing my position here, so I did move the rudder pedals around quite a bit, and could also be some turbulence actually, yeah. I think maybe some severe turbulence actually. Something I've seen a lot more of with the latest beta version 8.8.8.8 of Active Sky. At least we have some visibility. That is very, very strong turbulence. And I'm using realism mode, but in default setting in realism mode, default turbulence strength in Active Sky is 50, but with realism mode it is 60, and I have turbulence level set to low in the sim. So this is quite severe. Could even be realistic.
Echo Delta November Yankee Airport Information Foxtrot 1150 Zulu Weather Wind 246 at 7 Visibility 10,000 Sky Condition Few Clouds at 1,000 Ceiling 2,400 Broken Ceiling 4,500 Overcast Temperature 12 QNH 1015 Advise on initial contact. You have information Foxtrot.
Yeah, so the wind strength it's in itself, it's at the ground, is not too much to worry about. And it's just this turbulence here is something I've never experienced before with Active Sky or without Active Sky. So I am sort of happy that I am recording it. Because I'm sure that can be... great to use in a discussion about the turbulence strength on AVSIM. Very, very strange. So try and retrim this rudder a little bit. Alright, so the next waypoint is... Alright, so it's 4,000 is the final approach fix here. And it was 111.9, and we don't have it, it seems. Which is a little
bit boring. Uniform November X-ray. Contact Friedrichshafen Tower 134.3. Have a good day.
Over to Tower 134.3. Uniform November X-ray. Have a good day.
Alright, so I'm just going into heading mode now, and then it is 238, and it is 238. And we don't have the DME, but we might have the actual, yeah.
Friedrichshafen Tower, Uniform November X-ray, ILS Runway 24.
Uniform November X-ray, Friedrichshafen Tower, wind 040 at 4, runway 24 cleared to land.
Runway 24 cleared to land, Uniform November X-ray. And then we will turn around. A little bit of an intercept angle. Be a bit careful with flaps, so I think we'll wait with that. We will keep the speed down. And let's just check that we are ready here. We never turned off the landing lights, so we can turn off the prop and surface de-ice. And we'll just stay on this heading, I think. My lord, that is some really, really strong turbulence. That is crazy. A bit scary even, because we are really getting tossed around. How am I going to land this aircraft? Hopefully that intercept angle is okay, maybe a little bit more to the left actually. So we have to capture the glide slope too. I like to capture the localizer before the glide slope, so I'm not sure if we're going to do that. So what we are going to do then is that we are going to send 3000 in VS, and then we'll just go down about there, and then we'll go a little bit of flaps. So that we can capture the localizer. So here we go, localizer and approach. Okay, so we are in approach mode and glide slope is armed. So we will sorry. See here. I hate it when you zoom out instead of doing what you want to do. Alright, so we have the runway in sight. Are we good with Beyond ATC? Clear to land, yep. Clear to land, good, good, good. Let's try and do this somehow. Speed is not too bad. I think I might even go full prop now. I have reduced torque. And I'm just going to stay on the autopilot for a little while here. Wind strength was not too bad though. That is not the biggest problem. What? I'm sure I had 122.00. Why does it keep changing? So I shouldn't really be bothering about this one now, but I can't help myself. No, don't bother, just leave it. I don't know why it can't stay there. So we are approaching glide slope star in a way. About to capture the glide slope. Here it comes. Did I remember the landing gear? Oh, stupid joke. So we're on the glide slope now. We have tundra towers. We have tundra tires. Beware. All right. I again with the rudder trim though. I'm really glad that we could bring her because she has helped me tremendously with the ATC. Decimal 07.
Wind 2, 4, 6 at 7.
It's not too much though, so it's really the turbulence which is completely crazy. Alright, so autopilot off then. I'm not really sure if I'm going to be able to do this. We go a little bit more flaps. Trim down a little bit. This is wild. And dangerous. Too low now. But the speed is good. Maybe it will calm down. Nope. No, no, no. I mean, this would be highly dangerous, wouldn't it? Speed is too high. Let's go full flaps now and trim down a little bit. Stall speed was 54, I think, with full flaps. So just increase torque, increase, increase. No more turbulence, hopefully, fingers crossed. Not looking too bad now. If we get thruster on now, it's that's it, you know. We're down. Full brakes, and then let's see if. Oh, dear. What was that? And then flaps up, I guess it's a good.
Uniform November X-ray. Exit left at time.
Exit left at what?
Exit left at Charlie, uniform November X-ray.
Aircraft calling, request not understood.
I didn't say anything. I think we'll just go over here and then we'll terminate. Where are we meant to go then? Over here maybe? Maybe she knows. What a mess this flight has been. What a mess. And then left, yeah, and then straight. And then more left, and then... Yes! There we are. Park brake. What a mess. That was absolutely wild. I've never experienced anything like it. And well, I have flown in the real world in a much, much lighter aircraft. So I have flown much lighter aircraft like Tomahawk and Piper Warrior and that sort of stuff. And I've never been tossed around that much. And the wind strength was only 7 knots. So I'm not a weather expert, but I thought that turbulence is somewhat related to wind strength. And you have mechanical turbulence, and then you have thermal turbulence, which is related to temperature and sort of rising thermals, which I did experience a lot in the hot summers of Australia. Anyway, now that we are safely on the ground, miraculously, well, it did quiet down for the just before touchdown. Otherwise, who knows what would have happened to the aircraft. And then we will just make sure that we are idle. Let's try and use it now. We release the park brake, and then we hold the toggle reverse. Sorry. And then a little bit more. Yeah, there we go. That's the beta range. That is idle again. And I forgot that I'm supposed to use the... I thought the trigger button was my brake. Oh my god, what a mess. What a mess, park brake then. Anyway, so sorry about your head there. Sorry about that. Yes. And sorry to you too. We will go back actually. No? Could have moved though. So why don't we have a quick look at the airport of Bodensee Friedrichshafen, which is included with City Update 6. And it is home to Zeppelin. These lovely flowering trees is courtesy of Rex Acquisitions Advanced Edition. I think this looks quite nice. It's a pity that it's such a gloomy day, or it was many, many hours ago. What can we find here? This is a two historical aircraft, actually. I don't know enough about historical aircraft to know what they are. But the modeling is quite good. Can we find any Zeppelins? Wonder if they have sightseeing tours in those. I guess those, I don't know what the name is, but that is for snow in the winter. We'll have a quick look over at the other side. Ah, Zeppelin. We create solutions. I think that I will just talk briefly about something that happened when I was trying to troubleshoot why MSFS CTD so many times. Because on the fourth or fifth reload of the sim, I did have to install an update. And let's see here. Yes, I did have to install an update, and it turned out that that was another SU15 beta update. So that is we're up to 137.17.0 now. What is very, very interesting about it is this one here. Reworked the rendering of the world tiles to avoid graphical glitches under DX12. Remember, we had that at the beginning of the video, and a lot of people have said that there's no way they're going to include that in the beta. Well, looks like they were proven wrong. I was actually one of them. I didn't think they would do it this late in the beta, but it's a very welcome change. And it seems now that it's not all about Inebuild's Neon and trying to get that one ready for release. It is more than that. It's probably been revealed that this is the last sim update in 2024. The next one, as you 16 will probably not be until 2025, so I guess they are trying to sort out as many issues as possible. There are some other things here though, so that's what they are doing. That's why we are waiting, and should probably officially apologize to Asobo, because I thought it was only because of the Neo. And apparently it was not. So, there you go. I was wrong. So, this flight turned out to be quite different than the other ones in the series. It was a little bit stressful to me because of all the hardware issues that I had. And then another SU15 beta update thrown into the mix. So I had a lot to deal with other than the actual flying part. We also had some very, very strange and severe turbulence there into Friedrichshafen. So definitely this one was a little bit different because we didn't have any photogrammetry city to explore, but I hope that we learned something. I know that I did, not just about Friedrichshafen, but also about how to troubleshoot for some hardware issues and what to do when you get a blue screen of death. Initially I had intended to do a few short field landings, which would have been great fun in the Kodiak, but it is still going to be there for more flights, and I will continue to do general aviation flying along with my airliner flying. I like the variation, and as always I like challenges. So there are so many nice and exciting and scenic places to choose from around the world. And I'm not going to just stick to Europe. I guess the only limit is my imagination. And if you do have any suggestions as to where to fly and in what sort of aircraft and that sort of stuff, then you may leave a comment. So yeah, and that is it for City Update 6 by Captain Piett. I would like to thank you all for watching. And as always, until next time, please take care. Sieht sie nicht aus wie ich, mag nicht, was ich mag, redet nicht den ganzen Tag. Weiß sie, dass du an mich denkst, glaubt sie, dass sie dich gut kennt. Sie bleibt dir fremd, sie bleibt dir fremd. War das nur ein One-Night-Stand, oder glaubst du, dass sie um dich kämpft? Tu doch bitte nicht verliebt, wenn du sie nicht liebst. Ich glaub dir kein Wort, weil du immer lügst. Damit sie das wissen, sag mir wann, dass du mich noch nicht vergessen kannst. Wenn sie das wissen, sag mir wann, sag mir wann. Ich weiß, dass du immer allein bist, egal wer dich gerade einnimmt. Und immer wenn du heimgehst, weiß ich genau, dass ich dir fehl. Wenn du zurück bist, ich wunder, wunder mich dann nicht. Ich wunder, wunder mich dann nicht. Ich wunder, wunder mich dann nicht. Mich dann nicht. Bitte wunder dich nicht. Der rote Lippenstift ist von einer anderen Frau, weit und breit kein Kummer in sich. Denn das mit uns war zwar echt, aber nur ein schlechter Traum beinahe. Baby, mir ist kalt, ja, sie liegt in meinen Armen. Wieso wird es nicht warm? Fuck. Ist doch immer das Gleiche. Oh Baby, Tag ein, Tag aus. Ich parke wieder mal in irgendeiner Einfahrt. Der weiße Lambo steht vor einem schwarzen Haus. Und jetzt frag mich, ob sie dasselbe geben kann, was du mir gegeben hast. Mit dir flieg ich zu hoch, mit dir fall ich zu tief. Das ist zu intensiv. War das nur ein One-Night-Stand? Oder glaubst du, dass sie um dich kämpft? Tu doch bitte nicht verliebt, wenn du sie nicht liebst. Ich glaub dir kein Wort, weil du immer lügst. Damit sie das wissen, sag mir wann, dass du mich noch nicht vergessen kannst. Damit sie das wissen, sag mir wann. Es kann schon sein, dass ich allein bin. Egal wer mich gerade einnimmt, doch immer wenn du heimgehst, wusste ich genau, dass du hier fehlst. Wenn du zurück bist, ich wunder, wunder mich dann nicht. Ich wunder, wunder mich dann nicht. Ich wunder, wunder mich dann nicht. Mich dann nicht. Ich weiß, dass du immer allein bist.